Now we're going to talk about a way that we can make double bonds out of alcohols. And this is through a mechanism called acid-catalyzed dehydration. Okay? So how does this work? Well, remember back to when I've talked about leaving groups in the past. Okay? And a leaving group is even a concept from acid-based chemistry. All it means is that it's something that really doesn't want to leave, something that really doesn't want to get a negative charge. So another word for leaving group is just conjugate base, okay? So if you maybe don't really remember exactly what a leaving group is, just think conjugate base, back to acids and bases. And basically, alcohols are really bad leaving groups, or they're really bad conjugate bases. They hate to become OH minus. Why? Because OH minus is actually a really strong base. Remember that you always want to go from stronger to weaker. If we're making OH minus hydroxide, that's a really strong base, okay? So this is not going to be very favored to just leave a molecule. But it turns out that there is one thing we can do to make alcohol a better leaving group, and that is to use acid, okay? And if we can use some kind of acid, we can actually convert alcohol into an awesome leaving group. That awesome leaving group would just be that we add an H to it, we protonate it, so it turns into water. And water is an awesome leaving group because it's neutral. It loves to leave, and it loves to just be by itself in solution, okay? So here's the general formula. I'm not going to show you the mechanism just yet. That basically what we have is we have some kind of alcohol, and we have some kind of acid over water. Now in this case, I just put the general HA to mean really any acid, but your common acids are going to be, any of the strong acids. So H2SO4 is seen all the time. Any of the hydrogen halide strong acids. I've also seen phosphoric acid. This is not really a strong acid, but it's still strong enough to make the reaction go. These are all very frequently used acids for acid-catalyzed dehydration, okay? And what we're basically doing is we're taking an alcohol. We're going to be removing two sigma bonds. We're going to be removing the alcohol and a beta hydrogen. Okay, so this is my alpha. This is my beta carbon. Alpha and beta relative to the alcohol. We're going to be taking away two different sigma bonds, and we're going to be making one pi bond instead. Now, that general reaction of taking away two sigmas and making one pi is an elimination. So this is actually going to be an elimination reaction. Okay? Hope that's making sense so far. Now there's another reaction that you may have already learned or that you will learn soon, and that's actually the opposite. It's called acid-catalyzed hydration. Acid-catalyzed hydration is a reaction where we go from the double bond and we go back to the alcohol. Okay? This is actually what's called an addition reaction. Okay? Because if you remember back to the general types of reactions we talked about, that when you take one bond and you make it into two, that's actually addition. When you take two bonds and you make it into one, that's elimination. So hopefully that makes sense. So basically, the addition part is going to be the hydration. The elimination part is the dehydration. Okay? How do you know which one it is? How do you know if it's going to be a hydration or a dehydration? You just look at what you're starting with. So in this case, since I have my alcohol, I know that I'm starting with an alcohol and I'm going to try to eliminate it with an acid to become a double bond. However, if I was starting with a double bond and I used acid, then I could add water to it and that would become a hydration. Okay? In this step, in this video, we're just going to learn about dehydration, but I'm just asking you to keep this in the back of your mind later on for when you have to do practice problems with hydration, that this is the way that we tell the two reactions apart. Okay? So let's just talk more in depth about dehydration. There's a few facts I want you to know. First of all, the more R groups on that alcohol, the easier it's going to be to dehydrate. This is just a fact that might come up on maybe a conceptual part of your exam, or your professor might even ask you, give you four different alcohols. Which one's the easiest to dehydrate? Tertiary would be the easiest, secondary, primary, and then is the worst, and then, oops, sorry. I don't know what I'm trying to draw here, but basically that methyl can't even happen, because if it's a methyl alcohol, then, or methanol, that can't even eliminate because it's only got one carbon, okay? So basically the easiest one is tertiary, the worst one is primary. That's the first thing. The second thing is that the specific elimination mechanism that we use is going to depend on how easily the molecule is going to form a carbocation. Okay? And the understanding of carbocations is kind of essential to these two mechanisms. All that means is that, if you guys remember back to the trend of carbocation stability, that tertiary carbocations are the most stable and primary carbocations are the worst. Okay? And then obviously methyl is even worse than that, but like I said, methyl doesn't even get counted because we can't use it. Okay? So it's really the same trend as the one about ease. Basically, what we're saying is that the easier it is to make a carbocation, a positive charge on a tertiary carbon, the easier, not only the easier it's going to be to make it, but also it's going to change the mechanism as well. Okay? So what I want you to know for this section is that secondary and tertiaries make pretty good carbocations, okay? And then primaries make pretty bad carbocations. Okay? So I'd say these two are good, and that primary is bad, and then obviously methyl's out of here. Okay?